Hey, this is John from Two Does Bees and Gardens, and I'm going to show you how we put together a flower pot swarm trap. You can see it behind me, and I'm going to show you what we do. Well, first is this template that my buddy James and I came up with. You can see there's evidence of bees on this frame. We've caught lots and lots of bee swarms with these things. As you can see, this template is set for the ability to hold four frames. I'll show you how that works. Well, here I've got a kind of a nasty old frame. You can see it's got a little bit of drawn comb on it, and I'm going to put this into this template here. You can see it just slides right in between these dowels that we have sticking up, which just add support side to side. The way this is configured, you can see it will hold four frames. It'll hold two deep frames and two medium frames. And you see they just go in between these dowels. You probably can't see them right now. You can see them on the outside here. And we just lock them in with a little piece of scrap wood on both sides. One of the good things about this template is obviously it will hold four frames, but because of the diameter of the flower pots, they won't hold four deep frames. So it will hold the two mediums on the outside. Lately, I've not been using the two medium frames and just putting two deep frames in. And the bees tend to build comb in the place where these medium frames sit. I'll just take that out. I don't know if I can see it on here or not. But anyway, that's the way I have been using them. And the bees will often build comb right down in this area. You can probably see a little evidence here, right here where the bees had built some comb, and I'd taken that off. You can see even here. And typically what I've been doing is I cut that off, the comb that's there, and then I rubber band it into an empty frame and let the bees build it out in an empty frame. If it's nothing significant, in other words, they've built a comb, but they haven't really put anything into it. Sometimes I'll just take that and put it into a solar wax melter and make the bees start all over again. And I give them the wax from other bees that have been melted down. You can see on this frame, there's some yellow. That's where I've spread some more wax, and we're gonna give it a good coating. Here's one of the deep frames. You can see where the drawn comb, it's very little, but you can see I've also waxed that frame and put some more wax. Here is the wax that I've melted from my solar wax melter, from other pieces of comb or other hives, and I just kind of make little crowns out of it and scrape it across the frames. Okay, here are my two frames that I'm gonna put into the swarm trap and put it onto the template like I showed you. And this has been very successful for us. We've caught, I've lost count really, over 40, maybe 50, upwards of 50 swarms that we've caught using these flower pot swarm traps. Anyway, that's the short of it, and that's all I'm gonna show you today. You've seen the success. If you look at our channel, there are lots of videos where we have swarms in these flower pots, and appreciate it. Have a good one.